When an average person experiences rejection, their motivation diminishes. When a champion, a warrior, tastes rejection, it makes them hungrier than ever. The biggest enemy of greatness is the undisciplined mind. Anyone who desires success at the highest level must first conquer their own thinking.
Thank you all for coming to registration yesterday. Makes it all a lot easier to get you all in town, get you all settled in, get your groceries, get your water, get you registered, get you checked in, get all your appointments taken care of. We want to welcome you to the Golden Nugget here, and they are official host of Natural Olympia 23. They've been great hosts to us so far under the circumstances. There's lots going on.
I always say to you, train hard, train smart, and train natural, and always dream bigger. This IMBA and PMA was created for you guys.
Okay. I feel like I'm ready. Right now, I'm watching everything that I eat. See, if I eat anything, just one meal, it's bodybuilding, just one meal can ruin everything. So I'm trying to watch my carbs, because right now carbs is like gold. You see any kind of carbs, you just want to eat it all. So I'm trying to watch. I eat and watch how I look like. I don't want to ruin what I have now. Yeah. I already looking good from what I saw in the morning when I woke up. So I want to maintain it and keep on getting better until tomorrow.
I would like to go home for a visit.
Can you
see my son? Yeah. I was hoping going like October this year, but with the COVID, things like have been like upside down. So I'm planning now to like around January or February to go visit him, because I mean he's almost a teenager, so I would like to make sure that I keep that relationship closer by visiting him frequently, and then when I come back, then I would like to revamp my training, because right now I'm not training anybody except for like two or three people. When COVID came up, almost everybody stopped coming to the gym, and that's how all the training business went down. I mean, even the gym owners right now, they are feeling it. Most people are not going to the gym. We went to the gym here and it's like the gym is full. Like, you go to Wisconsin, it's like most people don't even want to go to the gym.
To revamp your personal training business,
mm-hmm.
so you can get more clients, make more money.
Yeah.
What's the goal? Why do you do the training? Do you do it to just make money, or are you wanting to just, you know, get a bunch of testimonials to? Like, what's the objective?
So for now, like, I'm still like not well known like you.
You're not well known because you don't want to be well known. If you want to be well known, you got the resume. You're fucking the world champion. You just have to promote that. I mean, that's the only reason I competed. So I can get the titles,
mm-hmm.
and make I want to be online empire. So that's what we did. Because I was doing personal training too.
Yeah.
But what I realized real quickly is I couldn't get to my goals because there was only so many hours in the day. And I really hated working with people like in person because it took so much of my time. I even changed my rate. I went up to like $250 an hour and it was not worth it.
What, $250?
I was charging $250 an hour.
For how many people?
I was training 12 clients a day. I wasn't making enough money. So what I wanted to do.
What do you mean, 250?
$250.
$250?
$250.
And most how many people? Like
12?
12 hours.
12 a day.
Times 60, 250?
Times 60 clients a week. This is a long time ago.
You can't do that in Wisconsin.
You can.
You can.
You can, because you're a world champion.
You can. People said the same
250?
Stuff.
He's really caught up on this small part.
Yeah, people said the same thing to me where I live. They said the exact same thing because nobody was doing it. It was unheard of until I did it, until I was doing it. It's all about what you think mentally. Like, that's how I position myself in a market that wasn't even created. But long story short, that wasn't good enough for me. I knew what my goals were, mm-hmm. and I would stay crazy about it. Like, even when people were telling me, oh, you can't do that. I've never even heard of that. That's crazy. That's outrageous. But my passion was to help people all over the world. I wanted to be online because I knew I had a skill set that nobody had. And I want to help people that were really struggling, not fitness people. Mm-hmm. I want to work with people that really struggle. So I basically, me and my wife, we created that online business. Now it's an empire. We got thousands of clients.
No, like
they don't pay us $250. They pay us thousands. And we're all online, which is way easier and it's scalable. Meaning I can get as many clients as I want.
Yeah.
So that was my goal. So that's why I'm asking you what the goal is, what the objective is. If it's just to make money, if you want to make money, like, what's the business plan? Like, how much money are you wanting to make? How many clients do you need? Then you got to figure out what the rate is. Don't think like, oh, I live in Wisconsin. These people. No, dude, that's don't set yourself back. Like, you are special. You don't do these competitions so you can be like Bojo the trainer. You're the world champion. You're the best in the world. People will pay for that.
So this is not my name, but I for my workout. It's called the red juice spread. Take it like 30 minutes before the workout. The reason why I like it is because it's stimulant free. I don't like anything with caffeine, and it feels great. So it has got all the amino acids that you need in every workout.
Yeah, a little bit more. Yeah,
I'm on the new level. I'm on the new level.
I'm on a 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 new level.
Brought me a new shovel.
Put this new in the dirt.
Chain with the new bezel.
On my neck, put it work.
I'm on a new level.
I'm on a new level.
Stay here.
Okay.
Wanna go?
I think
you
wanna do
tomorrow afternoon? No, I'm not.
Chicken. I don't know what happened to these plastics. It was super cold until it cracked. I can get like a steak sometimes later, but
you can get it all fresh. Fresh grilled chicken, fresh white rice.
What about this?
It's not exactly fresh.
Yeah, let's just go get some fresh stuff.
Yeah, I can have that later on.
This is good. Bro, you just put a brick of rice.
It's gonna melt.
Oh my god.
It's still frozen since like yesterday. Here, somewhere here.
Then.
But I was able to train for 1 hour. So on a Friday, a day before the show. That was impressive, so I'm looking forward to get some good sleep tonight so that I can wake up tomorrow feeling fresh and energy to be able to stay as long as they want me on stage. with the kind of people we have on that lineup, I mean, we might stay on that stage for 1 hour. Okay. So now it can stay there for 2 minutes.
Chris Moore, Meshack Ochieng, Dustin Pace, Ivan Puga, Robert Terry, Quintarius Wilson.
They end up putting the show, and all these gentlemen are here today, and it's going to be a good show.
Oh, it's going to be the best show, the best pro show I've seen all year.
I want to make it clear that there is something going on. This guy here, he's coming to take over from whatever that was snatched away from him. My friend here, he's coming to reclaim his title. He's coming to keep on winning, yeah?
Yeah.
So
I thought this was your job to wind us up.
I'm just giving him the mic.
What you doing right now?
Right now, it's just getting my... needed rest. Like I said, I didn't get enough sleep, so I will try to get enough rest as much as possible tonight. So I've been told by my coach that I need to put them up so that because this is the last area to dry up, so putting them up will make that happen easily. So